Hi, hello everybody. It's Amy and I'm back. I have been so busy this summer, but I finally had a chance to relax this week, which has been wonderful. Whew. Let me tell you, taking a stats class for 6 weeks during the summer online with little to no tutoring available at your school is, it's a very risky thing to do. But because I needed to get in to the nursing program at the time that I wished to be, I needed to push in and I needed to get this class done. Well, thankfully it's done and I've got the grade that I needed. Let me tell you, when I did the final, I doubted that I could do good in this course. When I was doing the final, that I would get the, actually, I doubted that I could get the grade that I needed because I didn't do as stellar as I was hoping in the two quizzes that I had during the semester. And I needed an exact 86 to get the grade that I needed in this course. And what do you know? I found out that I got an 86 on the final. And I was so happy. I was crying and I gathered up all my statistics notes and I had a bonfire. It was wonderful. And after that, I celebrated and I've been having this wonderful week. I went to the harbor beach and I relaxed on Monday. And then on Tuesday, I spent all day with my mother. I went to the hospital that I'm doing an internship with and I showed her the unit that I've been doing my internship in. And we went out to lunch and we went to Barnes & Noble's and just a very, you know, relaxing day, and it was so nice to be able to relax with my mom and just chit-chat like old girlfriends. And it's been just a wonderful week. But no more relaxing. Tomorrow I have to go back to work. So, wake-up call starts at 4:30 a.m. I have to get back to business. And I start the fall semester August 24th, so I have a little bit time until the fall semester starts, which is good, and I hope that I can actually studying, that is, for my courses that I'm going to be taking in the fall, because I ran into a friend who is actually taking the same course right now during the summer, microbiology, from the same instructor that I'm going to be taking, and she is very tough, very, very tough, and let's just say she made me just a wee bit nervous. So my books came in, I ordered everything, excuse me just for a moment, I ordered everything from Chegg, and I love Chegg. It is something that is very affordable, and my books all arrive so fast, always on time. So I guess I'll just show you some of the books I got. I got the microbe files, cases in microbiology for the undergraduate. This was a recommended book, but not a required book. It's by Majory Kelly Cohen, and I own this book now. It wasn't too expensive. I think it was $34, so I hope it's worth it. I hope it's going to make a difference. I haven't even look through the book yet. I'm renting this book. It's called Psychology Applied to the Modern Life, and it's by Wheaton, and it's the 11th edition. So this is my Intro to Psychology book. I hear this class is super simple, which is great because I need to put so much focus on microbiology because it's not an easy course, and I'm a little bit nervous about that, to be honest. Okay, I just almost started to reflect about my nervousness, but I'm going to keep showing you the books. And then this is my microbiology book. It's by Tortora, and I'm renting this book. It's slightly falling apart, but I think it's going to last the semester. In fact, I'm gonna just start skimming the first couple chapters and just starting to acquaint myself with the subject, because the student that I ran into who's taking microbiology right now, she said to me, she said, it's never too early to start studying. She said, start studying. Which scared me. The professor's quizzes, she said her multiple choice tests, all the answers are right, but there is an answer that is most right. That made me so nervous. Talking about nervous, I realized I have put a lot on my plate, just reflecting about it, a lot of my plate over this year, and I have come to question myself sometimes if it's too much. I mean, work, internship, school, and I realized, wow, it is a lot, and time management is going to be something that I've had to deal with and I need to become better at. Whew. Let's just say some of the things that I used to do, I don't do anymore, and there's a part of me that misses it because, my ums, I think, are adding up. But, as I was saying, I think that a big part of me misses doing some of the things that I like to do. I like to write, and I like reading, and for the longest time, I had a big goal of finishing all the Charles Dickens novels. I like hiking, I like getting out in nature, and I haven't really been doing any of those things, and I'm just wondering if sometimes I just wonder if everything that I'm going through right now, if it's all going to be worth it. It's kind of crazy them saying all the things that I'm going through. I'm just saying that it's been a little bit stressful, but I don't think that I've even come halfway through the journey that's ahead. I think this is just the beginning, because I'm finishing these last two courses, and then I'm going to be taking the TEAS test, and then I send out my applications, and then we see what happens. I know that it's only the beginning. I know it's not going to be easy, and I'm glad that I have a supportive family, and that I have a true faith that if this is what I'm meant to do, that God can pull me through. Well, it's been very nice talking to you guys and updating you guys about my life. I really hope to be making another video soon, and I hope that you guys are all doing well with whatever point in your nursing journey you may be. So, I will talk to you guys later, and it concludes this update for this video.